first time you leave, it can be strange, it can be shocking. Not everybody drives a truck, not everybody drinks sweet tea, not everybody owns a gun, wears a ball cap, boots and jeans. Not everybody goes to church, watches every NASCAR race. Not everybody knows the words to Ring of Fire or Amazing Grace. Oh, dancing land, I hope you understand. When I miss my Tennessee home, and
I tooted.
That's how you're gonna start the video.
Yep. It's what? It's Sunday.
But we always do small town Saturday.
Yeah, so we're just gonna do these back to back. We're still in Minneapolis, so we decided.
No. We're in St. Paul.
My bad, we're across the river in St. Paul. Like a half mile from the river, which is Minneapolis. So we're in St. Paul. And since we haven't really done any cute small towns since we last gathered with you all, we're just going to talk about all the fun things that we've been doing here in Minneapolis / St. Paul.
Commonly referred to as the Twin Cities.
See, then you don't even have to worry about which side of the river you're on.
Nope. It gets confusing.
It does. And the roads out here are kind of crazy. Like the highways, so mm-hmm. I don't even know what we're...
It's like someone took a bowl of spaghetti and mixed it all up and then dumped it over, and then they're like, yep, that's a great map of our city, let's do that.
Let's pave those roads. Mm-hmm. I think the highlight, well, a couple highlights, there's some really cute coffee shops.
Yeah, lots of local coffee shops. Mm-hmm.
Not none of them big brand ones, that came out totally wrong. Anyway, you get what I'm going for. And then where did we go yesterday? That was sociable?
Yeah. So Sociable is a cider maker, Cider Works. One, we weren't big fans. We prefer the bolder flavors, and they were a little bit more like almost trying to please everybody. And that
which
just
doesn't
work. Not for us. But we also checked out Town Hall Brewing. And they brew their own stuff, which I had their apricot wheat. I just sampled a taste of it, and that was really good. It's their seasonal one. And they also have a really good selection of ciders on tap. So we got a little cider flight sampler. And we also, Rachel got the milk and honey heirloom, which is very good. That one's made by Milk and Honey, and they're out of Cold Springs.
Mm-hmm.
And Angie, who we were staying with, went to high school, I think. With one of the three creators of Milk and Honey. So that was cool to check mm-hmm. that out. And then today we were at Surly.
Sorry, I still have my goat shirt on. my Surly shirt is inside.
You're saving it.
I am, because
for tomorrow.
Then I'll be clean and fresh. Not recycling shirts for the past few days. But this was by far the biggest hit.
Delicious.
They even, on their menu, it even said along the lines of, you know, we're not here to make beer that everyone loves, because that's boring. Mm-hmm. And that's true. Like Elizabeth just said for,
Sociable.
Oop.
It's fine. It just paused it.
Okay, we're good. I had a low battery.
Low battery warning.
But they were not afraid to go big and go bold and,
like, sassafras in their beer mm-hmm. and...
Cranberry.
The chilies.
Yeah,
Puya chilies? I don't know how you say
like that.
It.
The fiery hell.
Yeah, that one was good.
It was really good. And we got to go on a little tour.
Mm-hmm.
And learned a lot.
About how this was their 10th anniversary, their celebration this weekend. So we got to hear of, you know, how they progressed and even hear about how they're prepared for future growth in their new facility.
And they're growing.
Oh, yeah.
Like, in the last 10 years,
I mean, it won't be long before you find them all throughout this region up here.
Well, they're regional already.
They're growing that way, yeah.
Yeah.
So, if you're in Wisconsin, if you're, I mean, maybe even Michigan, we'll see them soon.
I think they're in Iowa, Wisconsin.
They said the Dakotas.
Dakotas, Minnesota.
So they're coming. They're coming. They have five different of their anniversary beers available. Beers. Most of them were like brown ales or stouts, and they were just, they're very good.
And even if you don't like that kind of stuff, it was definitely worth a try.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that's the fun part of the craft beer industry, the craft beverage industry. Everyone's so, I don't know, kind of old school, and they're stuck on your Millers and your Buds and, you know, all that stuff that everyone loves and is cheap to drink, but there's nothing to it. It's like cold, kind of slightly hoppy flavored water, whereas this stuff, yeah, sure, you're not going to like everything, but I guarantee you're going to like
something
on their tap. And that's the fun part. One, that I'm looking forward to making stuff and just tasting everything.
Mm-hmm.
Because there was definitely stuff I did not like on the flight. Elizabeth loved the
coffee one.
The double espresso something.
Stout.
Yeah.
Double espresso milk stout, I think is what
yep.
it was.
And I'm usually a huge fan of stouts, and I did not like that one. And there was almost like a porter-like.
Port-like. Brown ale. Was that one of the brown ales?
That wasn't the quad. That was...
Yeah, it was the...
Something
three.
Else. But yeah, it was a dark... I mean, but it was a fantastic. I mean, but that's
too
just...
sweet for me, but Rachel really liked
mm-hmm.
it.
And there was some that we both liked, and I think...
The cranberry stout, we both liked.
Yeah, we both liked that, and then the first one that... The quad bock.
They called it a quad bock.
Yep. Mm-hmm. So... I don't know, it's just really fun, and I think that's hopefully the way the industry continues to go, with people willing to branch out from the big guys and try all this fun, creative stuff that people are bringing to the table. It's going to be great.
We had plans to check out Indeed today, too, Indeed Brewing. We've had some of their canned stuff just from the store, but... The ones we had today at Surly range from like 8.8% to like 11.5%. And even though they were 4-ounce pours, whoo, man.
My face was furry by the end. And we had even eaten too. We're like, oh. So
we'll try to catch Indeed some other time.
Yeah. But it was good.
You can't buy like liquor here on Sundays, but all the microbrews that have their own tasting rooms can sell on Sundays, and you can go to the tasting rooms and stuff. So it's always a good time to go check out the local places.
What about food?
Lots of coffee shops.
Oh, Merlin's.
Oh yeah, Merlin's Rest. Yeah, we've been hanging around like the Lake Street area towards the eastern side of Minneapolis, and then we've also been on the western side of St. Paul. So that Peppers and Fries place,
oh, yeah.
The food was
that
good.
That was pretty good.
Oh, what was the name of that breakfast place where I got those upside down pineapple pancakes? Grandview Grill? Grandview Cafe? Something like that. Anyways, upside down pineapple pancakes, applewood smoked bacon, all of it was really good.
Yeah.
Well, we had those delicious, I think we may have already talked about them, the delicious pretzels, because we did a kind of Foodie Friday thing.
Mm-hmm.
Delicious jalapeno cheddar pretzels at Town Hall.
Yep.
Brewing. Oh, and then, of course, the pictures on Instagram today of those hog frites while we were at Surly. Very good.
Just Google that, and Surly, like, everything will come up, like... The top 10 hits are all from the brewery, just of people reviewing it and being like, oh my god, that's the best thing ever.
Mm-hmm. Good stuff. So even though these aren't small towns, we've definitely found some fun things to do. Oh, tell them where we went today. The first place we went today.
Oh, we went to the zoo, the Como Park Zoo and Conservatory.
Yeah, it's a really tiny zoo.
It's cute, though.
But it's perfect, I think, if you want to take, like, younger kids to the zoo, because it's not so massive that it's, like, you know, gonna wear them out. It's pretty small. But that's
and,
okay.
And we were slightly out of place. Like, I felt we needed to borrow a kid to be there. There was very few people that did not have small children. Yeah. So if you can get over that part, if you don't have small children, I mean, that's cool. There's a lot of cute little rides that I totally would have gone on if I had a small child with me. I don't think they would allow just...
adults.
Random adults to go on it, but it really is cute. They have some giraffes and ostriches, and they have a polar bear exhibit where they do a little show and tell about how they teach them or train them on a daily basis, mostly for...
husbandry purposes.
Yeah. Bison, and there was a couple lions and zebras and foxes and wolves, you know, your typical, but it was very small, but you can walk, I mean, you could do the whole thing in less than an hour. We did it
45 minutes,
and that was, we even spent like half an hour waiting with the polar bears. Yeah.
But I mean, it's free admission, donations, you know, only really. So
yeah. And it really is a great place. The whole area is a great place for small families, or with small people.
Small kids. Yeah.
And, yeah, that's pretty much it. Tomorrow we're going to head up back to Bemidji just for an overnight, just because we loved it so much. So maybe we'll have a few more things that we learn about Bemidji for our next Small Town Saturday. We'll see.
Mm-hmm. Well, and we'll also be around the St. Louis area.
That's true.
So, again, not really a small town, but hey, maybe we'll have some cool things to say about that.
So until then. Yeah, that's it?
That's it.
Okay. We'll see you later.